We are the Yugambeh Aboriginal Dancers, and we are traditional people from the Gold Coast area. In our language for welcome, we say Jingari, the first song and dances to welcome you here to our country. Jingari, welcome. The next dance is a dance about our people going fishing. This is about going fishing on one particular fish, which is the mullet fish. The mullet is very important to our people here in the Gold Coast area. The mullet fish would migrate from the cold waters in the south to the warmer waters in the north during the cooler months. When we see the paperbark tree just starting to flower, that's the very first sign for our people that the fish will start to travel through this area, and it's time to gather our spears and nets, head down to the water, start fishing. In our language for fish, we say jalam. Jalamala! The next dance is a dance about the boomerang. In our language, we call the boomerang baraka, the returning boomerang. Was not used for hunting or killing animals. It was only used as a decoy or to trick the animals. What our people used to do was go down to the water. We'd see a lot of birds sitting on the water, maybe ducks, swans, or geese. The men would then throw the returning boomerang out on top of the birds. The returning boomerang would do a circle or a few circles. The men would always whistle like a bird of prey, so the ducks or the birds would think that there was a bird of prey flying on top of them. What the ducks or the birds did when they were scared or in defense was all gather very close together, then fly low along the water, and up further would be hunters with nets strung across the river, and also large hunting boomerangs. Or killer boomerangs. Dance a boomerang, Karaka. Hey, Tom. in the dancing while we have a didgeridoo solo. Didgeridoo, just a hollow piece of wood hollowed out by the termites and the white ants. It's strictly a men's instrument, only to be played and touched by men only. The way we play didgeridoo, we vibrate our lips in a loose, relaxed fashion. We also have circular breathing, which allows us to play continuously for a long time without stopping. As the didgeridoo player begins to play, at the very start, I will ask him to raise his hand just to show you or indicate to you when he is taking a breath. Didgeridoo. The next dance is a dance about the eagle. The eagle is our totem. It's like our brother. The eagle gave us one very special law. He taught us we always hunt in the middle of the school of fish, never at the front or the back, because that's where the leader fish are, the boss fish. If we start hunting on those leader fish, the leader fish will take the rest of the school back out to deeper water, and we miss out on the catch until they come back into shallow water again, which could be a couple of days or even longer. Our totem, the eagle, we call Mipin. Hey, dance is a happy dance. It's a celebration dance. We do this dance with our children. They will hop up and copy and learn from their uncles, their aunties, their mothers, their fathers, how to dance, how to tell story, how to pass on our culture through song and dance. Today, for those of you who are Australian, this culture, the history, the songs, the stories all belong to this land, so it belongs to all of you guys as well. Thank you very much. Before you go, we'd like to give you an opportunity now to come get a photo with the dance troupe. We do just need a line to one side. We'll have a group at a time or a person at a time. We do have a professional photographer available. No obligation to buy those photos, but they will be available for viewing at the exit gift shop. Thank you very much.